Thanks for stopping by. Today I am starting a new segment on my channel that I call Books Start to Finish. And the first book I'm taking a look at is Lugosi, The Rise and Fall of Hollywood's Dracula by Corin Shadney. Now this is both a graphic novel and a biography of Lugosi. And Shadney did both the writing and the illustrations for it, which I think is really cool. Now, I came to this book by way of the author's previous book. He did a similar thing with Rod Serling called Twilight Man. And if you know anything about me, if you've watched some of my other videos, you'll probably glean the fact that I am a huge Twilight Zone fan, huge Rod Serling fan. And so I read that book and I really enjoyed it. I highly recommend you checking that one out. So, of course, when this book came out, I knew, gonna have to get it and take a look. As you can see, big fan of the Universal Monsters. I got my Universal Monsters shirt. Right there is Lugosi. And I'm interested very much in learning about his life. Now, funny thing is I'm not, like, very up on the history of Lugosi's life. I know a few things, but I would not consider myself an expert in any way. You know, I know he was originally Hungarian, and, you know, I've heard the stories about drug abuse and things like that, but I don't really know his full life story that much, and I'm interested in checking this out to see that. So, before we get too far, I'll just give you a little bit of the artwork in it, since it's here. Just kind of give you a sense of what that looks like. It's really good. It's black and white. And what I did was I read the first, like, about 40 pages. I read this much of the book to start it out, just to kind of get a sense of how it goes. So it starts out with Lugosi at the end of his life. He's going to a hospital, like a rehab, and while he's there, he's reminiscing about his earlier life. Then it kind of shifts to when he's a boy and gets into how he discovered acting and kind of how he went up in the ranks of acting in the like the Hungarian stage at the time. So that's about where I am, very early in his life, but it's fascinating. It's really interesting stuff. So what I'm going to do on this segment, this book start to finish, is I'm going to do, like I said, I'm going to start the book, and then I'm going to talk about it here briefly in this intro. Then I'm going to head on over and finish the book. I'm going to pause the camera and go finish the book. I've done something similar with some of my movie videos, so I'm going to do that with some books as well in this segment. So stay tuned, and in the second half of the video, I will come back on and give you my overall impression of what I am going to finish reading here very shortly. So stay tuned. Don't turn off the video yet. I will be right back very shortly. Okay, we are back, and I have just finished my reading of Lugosi, and wow, what an interesting story. What a tragic life he had, really, in a lot of ways, and this graphic novel biography really spells it out and gives you the full story from start to finish, and is really good. I'll just kind of touch on a few highlights, and then, you know, if you're interested, again, you can read it for yourself. But, you know, there's so many aspects of his life where he had hardships. One that comes to mind is, like, when he got the role of Dracula after playing it on the stage, then he won the role with the Universal film, it became a big hit. But the dark side of that is it kind of typecast him in these horror roles. And a lot of that also was because he was Hungarian and he had an accent. And so it was kind of hard to put him in other things, but he could do these horror roles with that accent. It worked good. But then a few years later, again, this was 1931 when he did Dracula. Then a few years later, the Hollywood Hays Code, which is like the production conduct code, really kind of kicked in and started being enforced. And this was where they would kind of dictate what was in good taste on film. And the Hays Code really went after horror movies. as a target for censoring what could go in, what was lewd conduct, lewd content, and other things like that. They really went after horror movies, and that hurt Lugosi's prospects. And he also wasn't very savvy business-wise. It talked about how he only made like $500 a week playing Dracula. And this was a time when there wasn't things like residuals. You didn't get money. You got paid for to do a job, like you were a plumber and you go, you know, do somebody's house. You know, it was like that. And once he got his money, he was done, you know. And he didn't ask for a lot of money up front and ended up having a lot of financial troubles in life. And that led to problems with marriages. And then, you know, the whole the drug addiction thing came out of pains he'd have, like, in his legs, like sciatica from doing stages all his life. And then it would give him, like, leg pain, and he'd take morphine. And that led to his addictions, which just kind of mounted up, just problems mounted as his life progressed, which is, you know, like I said, it's a sad story. Very fascinating story, but also very sad, but interesting. Extremely interesting. So, the author, Corin Chadmi, did the artwork as well. I'll show you some of that. I think it looks really good. And this is just, in my opinion, a fascinating way to get a nonfiction story, a biography. It's just a good way to lay it out, and you can consume it easily and in an entertaining way. So I recommend, definitely, if you got any interest in Bela Lugosi and his career and his life story, definitely check out this book, Lugosi. It's good stuff. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I plan to do this format again going forward. I think it's very interesting. The idea that I'll start a book and I'll introduce it in one segment, and then I'll come back at the second half of the video after having finished the book to give you my final thoughts. I just think that's cool. It's a fun way to do a book review, and I'm going to do that again here very soon. So again, thanks for taking the time to watch. I appreciate it. And until the next time, have a good one.